everybody. Welcome to You Create Art at Home. Bess is here, and week by week, as lockdown gets longer and longer, my family are getting less and less. So last week we lost Thomas, and this week we've lost Harry and Thomas. It's like 10 green bottles. By the end of actually opening up and no more lockdown, it'll just be me, I'm sure. But we do have David here, and we have dear Daisy here. So I will, and this is the first time you have done Sip and Paint on a Saturday with two screens. So I now have a funky new setup which has taken me and blown my mind and my husband's mind how to set it up. So you should see me in the little screen and you should see the art in a big screen. So you get two angles, which is super exciting. And it means that I can stand here and chat to you. We trialed this on Thursday with the WI in the UK, which was fantastic, except for the first 6 minutes, as I was giving a lovely introduction to this camera, I was on freeze. So hopefully, if you guys are on board and you're on live, then give me a heart, give me a thumbs up, and let me know that you can see two screens. Tell me where you're from. Who's hooking in with the live today? Who's up for a watch? And who's up for a paint? I don't mind if you watch or paint. I never have, never can. I just want to connect with you all and have a lovely Saturday evening. So please tell me who's on, where are you from? Give me a high five. Give me a love. Tell me which country you're from. Are you painting from Peru? I don't think so. It's 4 a.m. in the morning. But today's beautiful Peruvian painting is by the sensational Peruvian artist, 82-year-old Enrique Bustamante. And Enrique, if you are awake and watching, amazing. If you're not and you see this on the replay, thank you. Thank you for letting me use your painting of the beautiful pigeons of Peru for our inspiration today. I'm not gonna say that we're gonna copy it, I'm gonna try, but clearly an artist has their own way of doing it, and that's the most important thing. So if you see this on the replay, Enrique, why don't you try and follow me and see how different your painting comes out? That would be quite funny. We started off this evening at 5 o'clock with Larry the Llama for the little kids doing paint and picnic, and I had some lovely results. So I'm hoping that us adults, or maybe there's some children as well, can paint similarly fabulous artwork. I do not have any South American earrings to brighten your evening tonight, but I wore these really cool bright ones that my son made during lockdown out of FIMO. You can see they're purple and silver and lime green. So I'm hoping they're fitting for tonight's colorful South American painting. Who have we got? Oh yeah, we've got a few people. We've got, let's say hello. Hello, I'm gonna hold this so I can read it at the same time. I'm gonna say hello to Monique and hello to Gareth, my cousin in Cornwall. We've got the good old Cheezel Muncher, my beautiful friend Kath Sills. Welcome, thank you. Auntie Kath, welcome. Leanne, painting in Inverell. Inverell, David? It's in New South Wales. I'm glad you've come back, you've been painting regularly. We've got Holly Mitchell, yay, in the gap. Holly's ready to paint, awesome. Happy Saturday. That means Kath is just drinking. Kath, I'm going to be drinking with you. We have got Karen Wicks. Karen Wicks is one of David's gorgeous friends from school and is a beautiful friend from Bodmin, which is one of my friends too, but she went to school with David. We've got Jan Hoffman. Hi, Jan. Solitaire. Sol, are you painting tonight? You usually are one of my regulars. Who else have we got? Scrolling up from the top. We've got Ren and Sam Newman and Rebecca Hanley. I know Becca in Sydney. I know you're painting tonight. We have got Catherine Ross. Catherine, you usually paint. Are you painting or are you just watching and drinking? Either way, it's fine. We've got Susie France from the West End. Susie, you joined us last week. Welcome back. I'm hoping to have lots of fun. And Diane, you're ready to paint? Awesome, awesome. So, and here is Mum. Pam Selly is on. Mum, are you painting with us or are you going to do it on the replay? You're usually ready to go on a Saturday morning. My mum has done an amazing job setting up her spare bedroom upstairs, because of course no guests at the moment in the UK. So she set up her spare bedroom as an art studio. Super proud of that. Super proud, super excited. So like I say, we're going to do Peru today. We're going to give lots of love to our Peruvian friends in South America. It's all about the colour. I have gone big, and because I've gone big, I've got my bigger easel, which was actually too low for the camera, so it's on a box at the bottom, so it's been a right old shenanigans. Later on, when I start painting, if I talk to you, I'm going to talk to you in the little corner camera. Hello! So you're so lucky you get two of me today. How lucky is that? It's like getting drunk before you get drunk. Everything's in blurred double vision. So I'm going to be painting in your big screen. Now, I have upcycled a canvas. This canvas I have used about 3 times. You can see I actually covered it in paper. So here's my first top tip for you. If you've got a really skanky canvas at home, maybe it's a really dodgy picture that somebody gave you. Maybe it's something you bought from the charity shop that's a bit 80s, you know, one of those awful things in a vase. Just get some newspaper, some butcher's paper, something that somebody's wrapped your fish and chips in. You can get some glue stick, cover it over. So this is literally just covered in paper. I covered it over. You can just see the picture in behind. I did a sip and paint 3 years ago for a hospital in Brisbane. And their theme was, it was for the cardiac unit, and their theme was hearts. And so I did a giant heart, made it look like a knitted ball of wool. You can just still see it. So if you're wondering what that sort of shadowy look is, that's what it is. But I'm upcycling it today. I am doing it on this large canvas rather than the smaller one, because I'm hoping I'm going to keep it. This is the first piece of art that, out of all the ones that I've done, that I am going to keep. I want to share with you something very quickly. This was the fabulous painting that I did with a Cornwall WI. This is a Cornish tin mine. This is the Wheel Coats tin mine, and it was all about the colour. So if you enjoy tonight's Peru one, you might not know where Cornwall is, you Australians. It's the little toe bit of England. You might not know what a tin mine is, or, well, you might do because you watch Doc Martin and we all have, what's the other one? Poldark here, Doc Martin and Poldark, so you might have seen it on that. But you can see the colours are vibrant, and that is what today is all about. Plus, we're going to do some of this line work. We're not going to do it, we're not going to have the same colours, but we're going to have very similar ones, okay? So if you love today's Peru, you might want to have a go at a bit of Cornwall, which is where I am from, Cornish and proud. Pardon? Oh, comments, people are commenting. Painting with you. I'm doing mine on replay. Auntie Kat says, I need your technology for my story time. Do you, Leanne? Gail Fraser's watching. Hello, Gail from Sydney. Your accent is mesmerizing. What, my Cornish one? I know, I'm not very good at it now. That is really, oh, this sounds like all those people on Doc Martin that aren't from Cornwall, when they start speaking slow and they start to speak like that. But actually, obviously, I'm a little bit of a blend of London, Nottingham, Sydney, Brisbane. I don't know what I am anymore. Okay, bloody hell, love Doc Martin, so do we. There's a couple of my school friends in Doc Martin, actually, you'll be pleased to hear. When they film it in Port Isaac, which is about 15 minutes, 20 minutes from where my hometown is, when they actually close down the village to film it, if you're out and about, you can be an extra. It's so cool. I don't know why, but I was never there when I filmed it. Otherwise, I would definitely have been popping in. You know me, I don't like the limelight at all. Really shy and retiring. Okay, let's go, people. Let's get some painting done. So, I am being uber arty today, people. I am using my painting palette. However, I did do a teach. If you're into your art and you haven't got a painting palette, you can make your own. There is a quick art hack on my videos of how to turn a milk carton into a painting palette. Super cool if you, so not so much of a problem if you're sat down, but if you're stood up, you just need to be able to dip your brush in so they become really handy. So I used this week for one of my paintings, but I'm using my good old trusty friend, Frida. Meet Frida. I've had Frida since university days. Love, in love with Frida. It's like this. This is my signature look. This is my art smock, which I've had since university days. This is a Cornish fisherman's art smock. And last year for my birthday, I asked my mum for a new one. It's a little bit snug. I'm just gonna say it out loud, it's a little bit snug. I put it on, lockdown hasn't been kind to me, starting to get a little bit round, it's a bit snug. So thanks, Pam. I'm hoping in 6 months' time I'll be back into it. So I brought out my trusty pink one instead. Okie dokie. Now, because I'm painting on large scale, for my background, I am going super large on the old brush here, people, but I don't expect you to. I do have my other brushes down here. So you'll see me on this small screen, hello! And I'm gonna put my brushes here on this little, I've got two little stools there. And the first thing we're going to do is the background. Now, we wanna create some texture in the background, so I'm going to paint it. Now, I have texture from my paper. David and Daisy are doing it on plain paper, so they haven't got any texture at all, okay? So I've given them a sponge. These are like bubble wands or sponge wands. If you don't have one of these, whip to the kitchen, get underneath and get yourself a little scrubber out. It could be a pan scrub, well, obviously not a yucky one, and not a Brillo one, holy dooly, no, because that will give you pink stuff. You don't want to do that. But just a plain sponge that you can create some texture. If you don't want to do that, you can just use your fingers or a bit of toilet roll. But the bubbles in this will give you some nice texture. And I've no idea if Enrique did use a sponge, but I'm looking at his background and I can see that the back of his painting definitely has texture. Just before we get started, if you go onto my Facebook page and you look at my photos, you'll see I posted this picture. So if you want to put it, you know, if you want to take a screen grab of it and have it to one side so that you can refer to it, then that's a good idea, okay? All right, let's just see. That mum says that my accent is Bristol, for goodness sake. Is it landscape or portrait? This is landscape. We are doing it landscape, which means the wider way. If you've got paper, turn it so it's the wider way. Good question. Helena's on. Hello, Helena. And Sally is on watching. You're watching and watching. That's cool. All right, I reckon we're ready to go. Are you ready to go, Daisy? And ready to go, David?
Yeah.
Okay. So, the first bit, people, is to get your largest brush. I've got obviously a great big household paintbrush, but I've also got a big brush like this as well. I don't expect you to have a household paintbrush, but I've got to cover a lot of ground here. So we're going to get the paintbrush and we are going to paint it in blue. I've got blue, red, orange, pink, the teal colour, green and yellow. I did put up a teach of how to make teal or aqua or turquoise. And you need to, if you haven't made it already, when I'm chatting, make it, but you need to start with white, add a tiny bit of blue, and then a tiny spot of yellow, and that will get turquoise. But you need to start with white. Most common mistakes when they're making turquoise is they mix blue and blue and yellow together and get a green, and then it just makes light green. So you need to start with the white first. What's the matter?
It's turquoise, not turquoise.
Daisy's saying I'm saying it wrong. She just said it's, what'd you say it was?
Turquoise.
Daisy said it's turquoise, not turquoise. It sounds the same to me.
You said turquoise.
Turquoise. It's turquoise. Oh, for goodness. Duck egg blue, whatever. All right, let's get the blue. And I am starting up here, people. And I'm just doing it in lots of different directions. You don't want it to be, and I'm using my brush and I'm patting my brush like this. If I was using a smaller brush, I would do exactly the same. This is a bit wet because I washed it. So, smaller brush, big brush, it really doesn't matter. I'm just going to swap to the big brush purely because I've got a big canvas. So, we're going to cover, we have our canvas.
The whole thing?
Yeah, not too dark. Make sure that some of that blue moves around. If it gets too dark, you can dip it into a bit of white. This is the sky, and so because it's the sky, you don't want it super blue, okay? Super dark, sorry. Daisy and David, I didn't put any white on yours, so if you need to go and get some.
Yeah.
Just going to go in front of the canvas to do this side. This is super noisy. Daisy's making as much noise as she possibly can. I don't even know if David's painting, it's so quiet. David's got...
Dad's like using the tip of the brush.
So what's really lovely for me, actually, as you can see, because I have covered this in paper, if you can see, because I covered this in paper, I'm actually getting texture already coming through because of the creases of the paper. I know, isn't it beautiful?
Yeah.
I'm super lucky.
Yeah.
So you kind of want it to be in a sky blue colour, but you can have patches of dark and light, okay? Let me just check. Hi, Karen. Looking forward to this one. Oh, Helena, you're actually painting. Awesome. Hello, Joanna Grundle. Welcome from the Gap. This is the first time you've popped your little head in. That was after a chatting with me at the Friendly Grocer. Socially distant, may I say, socially distant. We were not close. But I happened to be going over to get some milk and I got waylaid. Met a couple of friends, Sarah Ashmore Smith and Joe Grundle. Had a bit of a chin wag. David was at home waiting for his cup of tea. He was not happy. Okay, so I'm just going round. How has your week been, everybody?
Are you blending it in?
No, I'm not. I'm just going to the very edges. So I was just painting the edges then, Daisy. And once you have put your colour on, if you want to give some texture, use your sponge and put your sponge on and peel it back and it will give you some texture. You can see I've got so much texture because I had paper on the cover, because I had this large canvas and I decided that I wanted to use the large canvas for you today. I've got heaps of texture that's come out. But you can get texture from changing your brush stroke, or you can get texture from using like a sponge or your hand, like you could put your hand and peel it off. That will give you texture. What I'm avoiding is trying to get, what I don't want you to do is have a totally blue background. I want there to be tones between blue and white, and I want it to look kind of rough and, you know, to have some sort of texture on it. Texture is so arty, people. This is me taking you into the world. The very, very, very elite world of art. You only get this from me. You realise that. This is very exclusive information. Okay, so I'm just rubbing in the background. Hopefully you guys have got smaller canvases than me, so you might still nearly be there. I think I am nearly there. I don't want to cover too much more. All right, I'm going to stop and I'm going to see. Please message me. Hello, Nicole Scott, you beautiful lady. Remember, so Nicole Scott is one of my gorgeous friends that I paint with at the weekend. Well, way back, before Corona. You know, one of those stories that you have before the war, or, you know, before this or before that. We're all good during the war, as Uncle Albert says from Only Fools and Horses, which no Australian ever will know what that is. But anyway, we're going to end up having a whole phrase, aren't we? Before Corona, before COVID-19. Yeah. So anyway, Nicole was one of my gorgeous...
I know.
arty friends, and we painted together at somebody else's business at the weekend. And she's a teacher, an art teacher, and I've asked her to come and do some painting here at my studio. And I can't wait for her to come do some teaching because she's amazing. Creative, colourful. The first day I met her, she had pink hair, and I thought, you're my type of woman. Okay, so what else have we got? That's it. Hashtag B4 COVID-19. I'm hoping. So tell me. So let's get back onto the art track. Give me a thumbs up if your blue is nearly done, so I know that your blue is nearly done. I don't want to move on too quickly because I need you to follow my drawing steps. So if your blue's nearly done and you're happy with that, then let's move on. Yeah, we got some thumbs up. Good, good, good. All right. So I think I'll press pause on the story and we'll go on to a bit of drawing and then we will come back to a bit more chat. You know I like to chat. That's what I likes to do, see? Why are you laughing, you two? Daisy just said, thank goodness that I've stopped chatting. I mean, I bring my family here. I even brought Tim Tams tonight, people. In English people, a Tim Tam is essentially a penguin. In England, they are so low down in the biscuit top 10. Like, it's probably, a penguin in England is probably like -3 on my scale of biscuits. In Australia, it's like the demigod of biscuit. But anyway, we've got Tim Tams. Okay, let's go. Now, have you got a purple? I don't want you to just jump into black straight away with the drawing. You can go with your blue, which would be your darker tone of blue, or let's get a bit of purple, okay? You can mix purple, which is blue and red, or if you've got purple already to hand, squeeze yourself out a bit of purple, and we're gonna draw with purple tonight instead of black. David and Daisy, can you grab yourself some purple?
Yeah.
I'm gonna talk at you in shapes, okay? Geometric shapes. So you should be able to follow it okay, all right? Okay, I'm using my larger brush. If you're feeling nervous about a large brush because we're gonna be drawing, go for a small brush. But right now, we're gonna draw. If you're using felt pens, or if you're using, I didn't even think about that. Is anybody using felt pens or colored pencils and has just gone blue over the whole background? If you have, awkward moment, tumbleweed riding through as I suddenly go, oh shit. If you are using colored pencils or texters, you might want to get another piece of paper and go, forget that, that was a great experiment, but I'm not going to use it. I might have used a lot of blue, but if you are using felt tip pens or pastels or coloured pencils, you're better off doing the drawing first and then you can fill in the blue blanks afterwards. Sorry, got a bit excited then. I'm just going to see, and now I'm going to see people going, shit, I'm using pencils. That was my last bit of paper. If it was your last bit of paper, flip it over. No one in the world is watching you. They're all watching me and thinking, loser, switch off, she's gone wrong. Anyway, if you're painting, let's go. All right, we're gonna start off down the bottom. Now, you need to translate what I'm doing to your scale, okay? Because whatever I'm doing here is large. So look at what I'm doing. Let's put in our halfway marks. So, side to side, halfway mark here, people.
In purple.
Side to side, halfway mark here, halfway mark here. Top and bottom, halfway mark. That's at least gonna give us a fighting chance of getting things in the right space.
I didn't want to do exactly halfway.
Okay, I have had nobody saying that they've done coloured pencils. Few, I think I've managed to avoid that disaster. They just dropped off. Wow, Anne Lane is watching. Anne Lane, I met on a cruise ship. Ah! When I went to Canada last year with my sister, I met Anne. She's from Australia. Beautiful, beautiful place. She's down from, I think she's in Victoria, down near Melbourne. Okay, we're going to put our first flower in. Now, I want you to do an oval. Look at my hand. The oval is not up and down. The oval is not side and side. The oval is at an angle. So if I was to say, draw an oval straight up, it is tipped over to 2 o'clock, okay? A 2 o'clock oval, and it's not thin, it's kind of chunky. So why don't you watch me before you do yours, okay? Here, I tell you what we're gonna do as well. Follow your line and put a purple spot in the middle, and you'll know where your center spot is. Okay, so this is how big it's gonna be. One, just having a good look. There is my, it's more like an egg shape because it's tapered here and wider here, okay? Tapered here, wider here. I don't want a point though. Do not put a point in. It's still got to have a curve, but it's tapered there and wide at the bottom. Give me a thumbs up that I've got good sound. So I know that I am speaking loud. I hope I'm not speaking too loud, but it's important that you can hear me. Hopefully you can see. I've got 3 lights on here. I can always put another light on if we need to. So that's my first flower. My second flower, so there's my center line. My second flower is going to start from this quarter, and it's going to be like a letter C. So it starts, so here's my center line. I'm starting to the right of my center line, and I'm going up, around, and it goes behind that egg and comes out underneath like a letter C, but I'm not drawing through the flower. Off you go. We got thumbs up, which means the sound is fine. Great. Loving this, people. It's going to be so much fun tonight. So like I say, I did this sip and paint for my Cornish WI ladies. There's 3,800 people in the Cornish WI. And I just wanted to reach out to this beautiful band of ladies that do so much for everybody else. These ladies raise money, they put on amazing events, they support their local communities. And, you know, they meet up every month, and obviously they haven't had that recently. And I know that because my mum is in the WI. I used to be in the WI when I lived in England. So I was delighted to do a sip and paint for them on Thursday. And I've got another one coming up on June the 6th, which is fantastic. Okay, the last flower on this side is going to go here. It goes from one side of your corner to the other side. And it comes up and goes down. A backwards letter C is the easiest way to describe it. And there you go. Back, corner to corner. So I'm super excited about doing another sip and paint for them. I'm going to do another Cornish scene. It's going to be a seaside scene, but it's going to be the same sort of bright colours with the same black lines, so that if you did love your artwork, you could perhaps frame them or hang them together. Sorry, Mum says it's the 5th of June. 5th of June, people. And I'm doing it at 7 p.m. English time, which means it's 5 a.m. Australian time. You're not like, pardon? 6 p.m. Oh, it's 6 a.m. for me. So if you fancy a... Huh? 6 for me. Oh, that's why I think it's the 6th. Mum, it's the 5th of June for you at 7 p.m. But it's the 6th of June for me at 5 a.m. That's right, isn't it, Dave? That's why. I like to get confused. Okay, I want you all to do another big letter C. You all right, Daisy?
Yeah.
Okay. So your letter C is going to come from here, and it's going to go, I'm just going to have a quick look. It's going to go up, down, and around. Ready? Watching me. Up, down, around. Need a bit more paint. Like that. Letter C. Do another letter C for me. Let's see if you can do a letter C. After after you've done that letter C, I want you to do the inside of the letter C. And I want it to widen on the bottom curve. So once I've got about halfway, I'm now going to widen it. So you can see the bottom of my C is wider than the top of my C. So I had a really nice chat with my WI ladies on Thursday, and one of the questions I asked them was, what amazing, unique things have you done in lockdown? So I had a hilarious response from one of the WI ladies that said she had been doing a Zumba Gold class, and she said it was not funny at all, but then all of a sudden the postman came past the window, and I think she was, you know, giving it a bit of that as the postman come down. My top tip to her was start yoga, and then the next day when he comes, make sure you're in a downward dog and see what he has to say about that. I love the fact that we're all doing these crazy things. So let me know what crazy things you've been doing in lockdown. My crazy thing has been suddenly filming myself online, seeing my big chubby skin. I did a kid's class, like, look, I'm not stupid. David told me once I have a t-shirt on today, because the other day when I was in my top and I bent down over the table, there was a little bit of showage. Bit awkward. David said, oh, I was just waiting for all the dads to type in and go, oh, that's nice with breakfast. Luckily, that didn't happen. Daisy's like this. Yeah, it was a bit embarrassing. Okay, so we've done. We've got 1, 2, 3 flowers. This is our little random little creature. And now we're going to put in a letter V here. The letter V here is actually like a tulip flower. And so it's got, it's more like a cup, like this. Let me just work out where it's going to go here. And we're going to go cup. So it's a curve. It's not a sharp V, it's a round, a cup V. As you know, with our paintings, we do it step by step. That allows bits to dry as we move through the painting. I've got absolutely no comments from you. Come on, is that because you're painting so seriously? What have you been doing in lockdown? I know you've all been trying new things. Some of you might have taken up knitting. Somebody might have done a yoga class. Let me know what you've been doing. And not just me, share it with each other. If you've seen someone pop on that you want to say hello to, say hello. Cross, what? Oh yes, you have to be careful leaning over, I do. I'm well endowed in that department. So let me know what you've been doing. Tell me what you've been doing. Okay, so I've done that flower. We're going to go up here now. We're going to do the inside of this flower. So the inside of the flower is a curve to the middle and a curve to the middle. And you should get, it's a bit like if you were drawing a bird in a sunset. It's kind of like a swoopy V. What? Sip and paint. Catherine has said sip and paint. So that's your first. Eva says, we have a square canvas. Have you got any suggestions for us? Eva, if you've got a square canvas, just do, so the main part of the painting is going to be here. Just do as much as you can fit in. There is nobody saying you have to do all of it anyway. If you want to just draw one bird, you can. So try not. I always, when I'm doing art, the other day on one of my 5 o'clock little kitty makes, I was drawing a portrait and the head definitely went off the paper. That's okay. It doesn't matter. Things don't have to fit. And if you try and make them fit, they just look out of proportion. So if you've got here and you've now run out of space, leave it. You'll still get an amazing painting. No one is going to know how much of the original you've done. So don't worry about it. Just do what you can do and what you can fit in. Trying to homeschool is one of the new things. Hear you. Nicole is a full-time kid teacher. She has no idea of the pain we are in the homeschool environment. What else have we got? I've started dancing in the lounge. Good job, with a dog. Love that idea. Solidaire has been doing knitting, cross-stitch, painting and drinking. Yeah, I've got a good practice in drinking. Daisy goes, oh, is that another bottle that went last night?
No, that was Tom.
I think they think that we've turned into alcoholics. We haven't, by the way. It was Friday night last night. Okay, so we've got that last one. Okay, we're going to move to here and we're going to do our first pigeon. Now, watch me for the shape. If you're drawing, you could draw this with a pencil to start with. If you're not drawing, then just watch. If you don't want to put too much paint on, try and make it a watery line so you can practice the flow first. What I basically want to do, if I do it upside down with my paintbrush, I want to go from here, I want to go down, around, curve and up. It's a bit like, that shape with a lip there and a lip there, like a bowl, I would guess, is the easiest way of doing it. So I'm going to go right to the edge of my canvas and it's going to come and it's just going to cross over that flower there. So here we go. We're going to go, let me see where I'm going to finish it. I'm going to finish it about here. So we're going to go down, around and up. Down, around and up. So it's finished about halfway in that flower there. That's the tummy of our first pigeon. Yay! Yay for dogs, Evie. Yeah, I know. Growing vegetables. That's a lovely idea, isn't it? I love the idea. We've just moved into a townhouse. We barely have room for a pot plant, so there's no vegetables growing. Homeschooling from Brisbane to Melbourne, Diane said. Oh, it's tricky. It's so tricky. The kids, I have to say, my kids have been amazing. Let me just say, they have been amazing. They're doing a really good job. I've got no complaints. But it's just hard with David working from home. He's got his headphones in. I'm obviously way too loud for the entire house because I'm just too loud anyway. And the kids, they're all wearing their earphones. We're doing okay, actually. We're doing okay. I'm not going to complain. Now, before we do the line that does the back, I want to do the wing, okay? The wing is a teardrop. Make sure I don't wobble my picture off. So it's at this angle. So if you need to, you could draw yourself a little line. I'm just going to go straight up and give it a go. So we've got a teardrop shape, and the bottom of the teardrop is right on the back. So here we go. It's going to be like that. A teardrop. If you need to maybe turn your paper round, you can do. If you are better drawing on a straight angle. Guys, can you all see my purple lines okay? Can you all see that? Hopefully you can. Slow down. No? Now these pigeons are not pigeons that you find in Trafalgar Square. I wonder if they're in isolation because there's millions of them. These are very bright South American pigeons, so they're very stylistic. So we're going to go straight across the top here. It's got a flattish kind of head, got a little bit of a bump, and then we're going to go down to meet that wing. Straight up, little bit of a bump, and down the back to meet the wing. What are you laughing at? You lot are funny. Jason is here. Good morning, Jason Williams from the UK. Are you painting or are you not painting? Heck, purple paint all over the floor. Is that me or you?
No.
You? Oh, you must be using a canvas, are you, Diane? Oh dear. Do you want to stop and go and get some paper to put down on the floor, like newspaper? That might be a good idea. Jason's watching today. Good job. Okay, the back of this pigeon. We're going to curve and we're going to meet the tail. So, curving at the back and down to a small curve at the tail at the bottom. Doing really well, guys. We're going to draw it all in. And because we're drawing it all in, all of our background is drying, which is going to help us when we come to paint the colours in, okay? That's going to help us enormously. All right, now right in the center of our canvas, about here, we've got another pigeon. You're going to do a letter S. So there's my center line. It's just to the left of center. There's my center there. It's just to the left of center. And I'm going to do a letter S. But the top of the S is really small. And then the bottom of the S is really big. Yeah? And it's going to go right out here and to the back. So that is the tummy of our pigeon. That is the tummy of our pigeon. Doesn't matter if you made them close together. If you have changed the structure of your painting, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It really, really, really doesn't matter. At the end of the day, you're going to get a bright, happy painting. And God love it, that's all we want, isn't it? Doesn't matter. Okay, this head. We're going to go up and over the top. So this is my pigeon's head there. And I'm going to stop there because we're going to put the wing in after that. And the wing is another teardrop shape. So we've got a teardrop shape. It's going to come from his back. And it's around like that. Another teardrop. Water drop. Nice, simple, bold drawing so far. We're doing really well. Daisy's got the giggles. And once you've done that wing, we're going to do the wing in the back. And the wing in the back is more like a leaf shape. So it's going to go up and down like that. More like a leaf shape. Pardon? It goes higher than that one there. So that one finishes there and that one just drops in the back. And then we're just going to finish the back and join round to the tail. Like that. Funnily, in this painting, Enrique does not put legs in his birds. If you want to put legs in, why not? Change it up. Make it your own, that's fine. We're going to say, welcome to my beautiful friend, Ingrid. Welcome, Ingrid. Welcome to You Create Art at Home and the craziness of Bessel painting on a Saturday night. It's mad, it's colourful, it's usually a little bit random, but we love it. We're hooking in from England through to Australia, through to New South Wales, through to Ireland, through to wherever you are. Hi, gorgeous. Beautiful Karen, not painting but following. Love the colours. Such a peace field painter. It is. This is actually, it won't be as peaceful as it is in a minute, because in a minute we're going to punch it up with a bit of Peruvian pink, a bit of cilantro green, a bit of margarita orange. I don't think margaritas are orange, but it sounded, they're yellow. Okay. David's yawning.
He's margarita cheese.
Margarita cheese? I don't think so. Okay, we're going to put in another pigeon here, babe, guys. Okay, this pigeon is a little bit smaller and we're kind of going in this gap here. So watch me first. I'm going to follow the diagonal like that of the back of that pigeon. Ingrid runs a business called City Chicks in Brisbane. They're backyard chooks. Ingrid, you could paint this with yellow chooks and you could hang it in your what would you call it? Shop. In your shop out in Sanford. So I've done the head, a little bit of a circle with a triangle for a beak. And then we're going to go a little curl underneath the thing. And then we've got that big fat tummy all the way around. You should know this shape by now. So it's like a big letter D, really D for David. There, David, you should be able to master that. And the wing on this one is a letter D as well. So straight down the back and the letter D.
D for Daisy.
I've got the two D's here. My two sons have flown the nest. excuse the analogy. Actually, they're not. They're at home on their own. And I've told them, if they're one of them so much as has an argument tonight, they will be here next week, regardless. We'll see how that goes. Okay, so we've got pigeon one, pigeon two, little pigeon three. We've got one more pigeon to go here, pigeon four, and one more pigeon here, pigeon five. We'll try it after a few bubbles. That would be a gorgeous idea. Okay, so let's go and put this last pigeon in over here. I'm going to have to stand in front of it. The head starts up at the top, so I'm just going to put a curve there. We're going to go right down and do his back, and it's going to go right to the edge of the canvas. This one is going to be a little bit obscured, and that's okay. There's his beak. And curve under, and there's the down for the tummy. So far, so good. Computer's just turned off. There we go. Now, I forgot to put in the one wing here. This wing here is like he's open, saying, "Welcome! Welcome to my Peruvian world." So let's put in a welcome arm. Curve and to a point, point and to a curve. So it goes back in. It's like a welcome. Curve to a point and curve that way. So curve one way, curve the other way. It's like the bottom of a heart. It is a bit like a leaf, Daisy, you're right. Which means we can then put in our tummy of our last pigeon because it just tucks in behind. Actually, I've made that a bit low. The tummy needs to go up to about there. So I'm just going to wipe that off. Otherwise, he's a bit fat, you're right, Daisy.
I have a fat chicken.
You have a fat chicken? They're not chickens, they're pigeons.
They're pigeons.
Daisy's got a fat chicken. We haven't even been doing chickens. Okay, just patching up that with a bit of blue. See how easy it is if you make a mistake? You just work around it, wipe it off, and off you go. You're still there. So, Australia has started its 1-2-3 phase rollout after COVID-19. First phase starts next weekend, is that right, Deeps? Starts next weekend. And pretty much, shops are open, correct? Hairdressers, I think. Restaurants with 10 people. Shopping malls, I think. You can have a group of 10 outside your house, and you can have 5 people from the same family inside your house. So things are starting to change, which is super exciting. The kids have still got 2 more weeks of homeschooling. Got 2 more weeks of homeschooling, but we are starting to see light at the end of the tunnel. They are, I think, by step 3, and the 3 steps are going to take 3 months. Is that right, Deeps? Mm-hmm. I think it's going to take 3 months. So we're in May, June, July. August. By the end of July, early August, the state borders will be open. We'll be able to travel around Australia. No idea about international travel. Okie dokie, so we've done our last pigeon. We need to put in the 2 wings. So it's going to go from the top corner here, down and around. So you've got that teardrop that goes right up to that top corner. And then you're going to have a second one that just matches. It's in parallel, right next to it, and it matches. So that's the 2 wings of that little birdie wordy. We've got one more bird to put in, and then we're going to do some flowers. And this little bird is going to go here. And the easiest thing is to put in his tummy first, which is like, what shape is that? It's like a backwards L. It's like a backwards L, or another S actually. So if I start there, small curve for the top of the S, down round for the big S, and then straight across the bottom. Yeah, so it's like a letter S, but it's only a small swoop and then it's straight across the bottom. This then becomes the beak, so let's make that into a triangle. You should understand the shape of this now, so curve up round the top for the head. Round the top for the head like that. And we're going to bring that swoop and bring it down to here. So swoop round and then down there. This one's got two wings. It's got one at the back, which is going round and down. Oh, that's a bit wide, but I can live with it. One that goes round the back. And this one curves down and it's going to nearly touch its bottom. So we go down and around. It's like, so when I was chatting with Enrique Bustamante, who is this beautiful 82-year-old Peruvian artist, just divine. And as I, you know, I've done a Banksy and I've done the Picasso, which is up here, and I've done a George O'Keefe and various different things. You know, a lot of those artists, Monet, they're all dead. Enrique was still living, so I felt like it was only right to actually contact him and say, is it okay if I use your painting? And we had a half an hour, thank you Google Translate, we had a half an hour chat, and he thought it was so exciting that we were doing this painting. He was absolutely blown to bits. He was explaining to me that the pigeons, when there's a storm or if they're scared, they all kind of come together and they huddle together in safety. And they bring their families close in a brood. And I thought it was an amazing analogy to what we've been going through in COVID-19. So I was super thrilled to paint it. All of the line work and the dots are all very symbolic to indigenous South American ancestral references. Very similar to Australia, really. Okay, so we've got our last one there. You just need to do the inside of that wing to join it up, and that's our last little pigeon. Let me move. I don't know why I'm stretching so far to reach that palette. I really don't. Okay, do we have any questions? Amelia, welcome. Ah, Diane says not all states. Can't make the whole live video, but looking forward to having a go tomorrow. Great, Amelia. I can't wait to have you have a go tomorrow. Beautiful job. So we've done 90% of our drawing now, people. We're going to put in the flowers and then we're going to start colouring it up, okay? So, if you need to stop for a cup of tea, you want to get a glass of water, I'm just going to top up my wine, please do. Send me a message, send me some love. Tell me where you're watching from if you haven't done already. Or, you know, just tell us a bit of fun. Tell me something. Tell me, what would you like to tell? What can they tell me? Daisy, ask them a question. What did you have for your breakfast or what did you have for your supper? I had the most beautiful pad thai, and Daisy has made me today, straight from Google, a lemon drizzle cake for tomorrow for Mother's Day. What have you eaten that's fabulous today? Tell me what you've had.
We had Tim Tams.
And we have, where's the Tim Tams? In the fridge. Let's get up the Tim Tams. Oh, where are they?
They're here.
Oh, okay. It could be Tim Tam time. Can I get a beer for you? I definitely can.
I'll get one.
Can I get a beer for David? Yes. Oh yes. Can I get a wine for me?
Yes.
And can I get a Tim Tam?
I said yes.
Oh yes. Here it is. Here is the elusive Tim Tam for you English folk that might not know what a Tim Tam is. This is the Tim Tam. It's essentially a penguin. So we had Leanne had pumpkin soup. Yum. How many chickens have I got now? They're not chickens, they're pigeons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five pigeons. Five. Diane had homemade vegetable soup. Nanny, who is my mum, had a VE Day celebration with Cornish cream tea. As we all know, that's victory in Europe. 75 years VE Day celebration. All of my family seemed to go out and have these amazing street parties, but everybody was sat in their chairs, in their front of their garden, chatting with the neighbours who were over their fence. It looked amazing. What else have we got? Helena, the boys made homemade flatbread. Yum! And we used them to make tacos. Oh, Helena, I'd love to get that recipe from you, because would you like to have a go at that, Daisy?
It with says, flour, Greek yogurt.
Must be something else. Just flour and just Greek yogurt. No water? Awesome. And then do you roll them out with a rolling pin? How do you work that? How do you make a flatbread? I don't understand. And Evie had Thai green curry. Chicken. Yum. Alright. I've had my Tim Tam. I'm going to have some wine. And we're going to go for it. I'm going to swap to a smaller brush. And we're going to put in these flowers. Now, the flowers pretty much are what I would class as your atypical kids' flower. I don't mean that any disrespect, Enrique, at all. But that's the easiest way of explaining it to beginners. So you have circular centre, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 petals around the outside. And it looks like all of his are the same. So follow me. I'm not going to go one here, one here, one here, one here. You watch me and you'll see where to go. Let's put in all these flowers. The first one is going up here above the head of this pigeon. So you can see fairly even sized petals, fairly even sized flower. Next one in this corner. Still painting in purple. Awesome. The next one is, well, look, here's the first instance. I don't have enough room here. It should be on Enrique's picture. It should be right there. I don't have enough room between my pigeon and that flower. So I'm just going to move it to one side and I'm going to paint it here. If your petals would go behind the pigeon, then just don't paint all of it, okay? So paint the shape and let it duck in behind what you've already drawn. Don't paint over it, let it duck in behind. There's another one that goes in here. And again, you're not going to see all of it, you're just going to see the centre and the petal work. Okay, we've got one big one down the bottom. Oh, Helena said super easy, just one cup of each. Oh, I'm going to give that a go. I fancy having a go at that. David, how are you thinking that this is a painting is quite simple so far? Yeah? Is it?
Yeah, it's mine long.
Is it? Let's have a look.
It's a bit squishy.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah, David's saying we need some colour. I don't disagree with you there. Okay, there's one little shape here.
Inside.
Just there. So you see what that inside C is? You're just going to do a little bit. It makes a kind of leaf shape. And then you can put a flower here. As soon as we've done these flowers, people, we're going to be putting in some colour.
Yeah.
and then that will start to make it all look amazing. Okay, I've got one flower up here and it's kind of off the edge. So I'm just going to put the flower, you're not going to see all the petals. Just put in as many, if you haven't got room to do all these flowers, Daisy's just saying, I'm just going to do three flowers, then just put three flowers in. You really don't want to squish them in. You want to have some room to breathe in your painting. So if you can only put in three, just put in three, okay? Don't panic about it. There is no point. Okay, down here, there is like a little chicken. If you don't have room down, have you got a space down the bottom, Daisy?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah. So there is a space for a chickeny kind of thing. So I'm going to draw it here. It's the letter S again. So the head around and down to the edge of the paper. If you don't have room or you really don't want to put it in, don't put it in. Okay? Make those choices yourself. This chickeny thing is going to be quite a different colour than the other pigeons. It's obviously not a pigeon. This is a bird as well, can you believe? And its wings are quite different. So we've got two wings and they go up towards the letter C. They go like this. And they've got kind of like a sharp edge to it. Then this one here is the second wing. And again, it's got a sharp, feathery edge to it. So it looks quite a bit different than the pigeons. And we've got one more thing to draw before we start painting. And that's the head of this funny little thing here. I don't even know what type of animal this is. Maybe it's something in South America. It's like a triangle for the nose and a curve on the top. It's as simple as that. I don't know what it is. I have never seen anything like it in my life. But anyway. Okie dokie, people, let's have some fun. Let's start putting in some colour. Diane Broad, my beautiful best friend from Brisbane, has clocked in. This is the first time I've seen you pop in, Diane. She is a very creative soul. She'll tell me she's not, but I am glad she's finally come to one of my sip and paints. You can't sit down, you can't see. Oh, there's one more little flower in there. Okay, follow me with the colours. We're starting off with cerise pink. I'm gonna paint this shape in here. If you haven't got exactly the same tones as me, don't worry about it. Just make up your own colours. They can be whatever colours you want. Okay, do not stress about it. And if you can't get the brightness that you want, then maybe we need to do two layers, but that's okay, we can do. So use what, if you don't have these colours, then just use the colours that you do have. There is nothing to say that you have to use the same colours. It's all about using what we've got, being adaptable. If you want to make a blend instead, you can. It's entirely whatever you can create, okay? So we're just going to stop block colouring all of these beautiful colours in. Yours won't be as big as mine. Remember, I am painting in a large scale today. Going to have another little sip of my wine. So I also had a request from somebody when I said where else should we go and paint. Someone said to me Iran. So I'm not sure if it was you, Helena. Somebody said about doing Peru, which is why we're doing Peru today. And then somebody also said Iran. Well, I started doing some research on Iranian art and I did find a lovely lady who I was really, really keen on. But you know, her work was there and you could view her work. But do you think I could find any details about her? Well, I know you're probably not surprised because, of course, you know, in that culture, women are kind of seen and not heard, aren't they? So I wanted to connect with her because she's very much alive. And like I connected with Enrique to ask his permission to paint this painting today, I really wanted to reach out, but I could not find, no matter how hard I tried, I could not find any contact details for the lady at all. So that was no good on there. But we might still do her artwork. If anybody else has a painting that they would be like, they would like me to consider, then please let me know. Remember, we're trying to paint things around the world. We're trying to support everybody as we travel around the world, and we're trying to support everybody from different countries that are going through COVID-19. So give me a country, let me do some research.
Mom?
Yes.
Is the egg shape pink as well?
The egg shape is pink as well? Yeah. Hot pink, baby, hot pink. So yeah, if you've got any ideas to somebody, maybe it's an artist that you've always liked, that you really fancy having a go at, you just need someone to show you how to paint it, I'll have a look, I'll have a little practice in the studio, and then we'll give it a bash together. I mean, I've never painted any of these paintings at all. The only painting I've done before is none of them. Any of the paintings I've done, I've never done any of them before. So we're all in the same boat. We're all learning together, people.
Is the middle of the flower pink as well?
It is, but it's kind of, yes it is. Don't worry if you go over your purple lines, because we are doing black lining at the end. This is just to do the drawing, because if we draw it first, it means that when you paint it, you can speed up. You know, you can paint much quicker, because you know where everything is. So my key right now is to block colour everything in. Then we'll start to detail it, and then we will do black lining at the end. And it's a bit like baking a cake. Gonna look like crap to start with. You're gonna have flour everywhere, eggs everywhere, a right mess in your kitchen. You stick it in the oven, you take it out, you stick some icing on, and then you think, oh my god, how did I make that? This is another pink flower here. It's already starting to look more vibrant, don't you think? I think so. Oh, I'm going through buckets of paint here, peeps. Big canvas, lots of paint. So, Diane Broad, am I going to get you painting, my young lady? What's the families look like? Okay, I can show you the families. Let me just finish this pink flower and then we'll take a whiz round, Helena, and you can see what everyone's is looking like. And David's going, no! Bearing in mind, I've lost two of my family. I normally come with four. Last week I came with... No, I normally come with five. Last week I came with four. Thomas said no. This week Harry said no. So we're down to me, Daisy and David this week. Next week it could just be two. And then next week, the week after, it could just be me.
No, I'm still coming.
Daisy's still coming. Good on you, Daisy. David! David just said he'll drop out. He can't. He's not allowed. This is our date night, Dave.
And why am I here?
Because you can... That's weird. Let's not talk about that. Can't talk about why Daisy's here on a date night. That's weird. Right, let me just check my colours. This one down here. I'm going to finish all the pink, Helena, and then I'm going to take you round and show you the family. So this one down here is pink. I'm not too worried about, you know, making it super well painted, because I'm going to put black lines on it in the end. So I'm just getting that colour in. What's the matter?
Nothing.
There's one more pink shade here that I missed. So I missed one pink shade there. behind the chicken, behind the tulip, there's just one extra little pink shape. With paintings like this, it is very much easiest to paint colour by colour, because then you can, you know, wash your brush out, you can do one colour at a time. It makes much more sense than trying to do each little item first and then keep washing your brush, which just drives you crazy. Okay, I'm just going to add a touch more pink to this one because my blue is coming through. If you feel like you want to give thing a second coat to brighten it off, then do. I've just added a bit more to cover the blue there. All right, I am going to my little picture that's in the corner. Hello! This is the camera I will take you around to show you the family, okay? So you'll only get to see a small view because obviously I've got the big camera on the top. So are you ready? Hold on tight. I'm just taking you for a little walk. Are you ready? Let's go. And around the studio. Here we go. Here's Daisy and David. Oh, cool, Daisy. Nice bit of texture. Let's have a look. Gorgeous. That's beautiful. Yeah, that's great. Looks gorgeous. David, nice. Oh, good job. Can I tell what it is there? No, not really. So you can see that here's my rig. You can see the rig. So I've got an easel set up here. I got a plank of wood over the top, another easel there. This has taken David and I about 2 weeks to work out. But I got a couple of little laundry baskets. So I've got my lights clipped up there. There's my camera, which you are looking at. There's one camera. There's my computer, which is mixing all of the streaming together. Here's the picture I'm copying. And then here's you lot on my screen so I can hear. You'd never be an art school dropout. So I can read all your words and I can see what's going. And then that camera sits over here so you can see me. And that is, you create art at home. Oh, hang on. Oh no. Oh dear. Dave. Okay, I've now jimmied it. I don't know if the picture's dropped out or not.
It's still there. Backwards.
Okay, so you're having a look. Oh, there you can see up my nose. Always a nice look. Let's put you back on. That was fun, wasn't it? Can you see me? Can you hear me? Can you see me? Am I still in the corner, David? Hello! Unfortunately, he says yes. Okay, we're now going to use the aquatone to paint our pigeons. I'm letting that pink dry and we're using aqua. So watch your brush out if you don't have aqua. So to make aqua or turquoise or turquoise or turquoise or however you pronounce it, you need to start with white. Then you add a touch of blue and a touch of yellow. Mix it. If you use too much blue, you'll get a blue colour turquoise. If you use a touch more yellow, you'll get a green duck egg yellow, a green duck egg blue. It's fine, however you make it is fine. If you have one in a tube, just use the one you've got in a tube, okay? All right, so I'm going to use the colour we've got. But the pigeons have two tones, and I'm going to do the first tone first, then I'm going to add more blue to make a more blue colour. So follow me if you want to do the same. If you just want to paint it blue, okay? All right, so the first tone of our pigeon is this one here. Oh, I'm loving the colour, David. It's awesome. This colour is my jam. In fact, this painting is my jam. Cerise and aqua, totally my jam. Daisy, if you haven't got a paint, if you're missing a bird, don't try and squeeze it in, honestly.
Yeah, I know, but I didn't do it, so I do any others.
Just wait until we catch up. Okay. If you're missing a bird and you haven't got room, don't try and squeeze it in. Just wait until I get onto the next one. There is no point. You'll just make it worse, okay? You've got a good composition now. Stop with where you're at. It's only your painting. No one's going to look. No one's ever going to look at my painting alongside yours, are they? Ever, never. So it doesn't matter. Okay, that's a total lie because I'm going to put all your pictures on my Facebook page and everyone's going to see them. Ah, dear. All right, let's put on this one. This one is Daisy. This one is David. He's the big daddy in the middle. This is my family of pigeons here. Daddy is in the center stage. He's the boss. This is my family. I'm going to call, this is a picture of my family. I love it. Yes, definitely. Daisy is the one at the back because she's got her wing open. She's so nurturing and loving. And that is my daughter. Wouldn't you agree, Deebs? David just said, our family is a bunch of flying rodents. Yes, we are. They probably a delicacy anyway. So you know how for the other sip and paints, we've been eating as a family, we've been eating meals from that country. Well, I was going to do ceviche because I do like a good ceviche. But I started to Google dishes of Peru. And the kids were horrified when I found out one of the dishes was deep fried guinea pig. They were like, ah, no! So we didn't go down there. And I did explain to them around the world, everybody has different foods. And as weird as it is to us, you know, in France they eat horse. In China they eat dog.
We
you know,
kangaroo.
We eat kangaroo, let's be honest. Okay. This open wing here. Is this colour? So if you're following me in colours, this first blend, that wing there, and then this back wing on here, the rear wing on this bird here. I'm going to say this bird here is Thomas, because Thomas is growing up, he's 14, he's starting to think that he can fly the nest, not a chance in my opinion. This little dude here, this is Harry. Harry's always looking in the wrong direction, so all the family are doing one thing, he's always doing something else. This is Daisy, this is David, and this is me. Oh my God, I've missed a wing. People, we missed a wing. Mother's only got one wing. Stick in your extra wing. How did I miss that? Sorry.
That's kind of sad, I didn't do me.
You didn't do you? Oh no! Daisy, maybe, Daisy's missed herself out. Maybe you can be a flower, Daisy, in your painting. The only reason why I've just noticed that I haven't got that wing is because this is the same color. So I was looking at the painting going, right, where else is that blue? And I noticed that there was a wing there. And I was like, have I got a wing? I'm one winged. Question? Got a question. Why isn't the teal covering the whole body? On which body? So, let me go through it. The teal is covering this part of the body, this wing, this part of the body, this wing and this wing, because we're going to use two tones. So in a minute I'm going to add more blue to that teal and it's going to make a bluer color, and the other part of the pigeon will be in that color, so it's two tones. The big one, this one here, because the wings are going to be in a different color. This one here, this body and this wing is going to be in a different tone. Does that answer your question? Hopefully. Solitaire said, I tried guinea pig when I was in Peru. Sol, what was it like? I need to tell the boys because we had this massive debate. I showed them put paint on my ear. I showed them a picture and there was literally a plate with a deep fried guinea pig on it with his hands out like this, and his mouth. It was awful. Oh, it's the light, sorry. Okay, I see what you mean, it's the reflection. If I just turn off that one, no, turn off that one. If I turn them both off, you'll you'll be able to see. Then there's no glare. Is that better? So you can now see, and obviously I've got the lights on, so you've got the bright, but now hopefully you have a quick look and you'll be able to see without the glare that it's the whole of the body is actually painted in. But I'm going to put the lights back on, because otherwise it's too dull, the colour is too dull. So now you can see, okay? Well, let me ask you a question. Is it better with our lights off? Would you prefer it with the lights off? Maybe that colour is better for you. And if that's fine, I can leave the lights off, okay? If you want me to leave the lights off, it tasted like chicken. It's a bit like frog's legs. They say, I've eaten frog's legs in France and they taste like chicken too. Yeah. Shall I keep the lights off? Yes? I think we might keep the lights off. Shall we keep the lights off? Yes? Or?
No. N-O.
Okay, let me know yes or no. These are my buttons that I have in class for the kids. And of course, all we have all day is this. No!
No!
No. Either way, it's a bit of fun. Keep the lights off. Okay, let's keep the lights off. All right, so now I want you to mix a tone. So if I show you on here, this is my aqua blue. This is my darker blue. I'm going to move some of that aqua into that blue and I'm going to mix up. It's still a teal colour, but you can see I'm adding that blue into it. So you can see it's much bluer. I need a bit of water in there. It's less glary with them off. Fine. Okay, Mum says put them on. We'll do a bit of both. We'll paint with them off and then I'll put them on and then I'll turn them off. What did they say?
Is
you can please
blue?
Some of the people all of the time and all of the people some of the time.
Is it dark blue and white?
So it's the turquoise with a bit of the dark blue. And basically we're going to start with this dude down here. This is me. Bess is in this corner. We're going to paint Bess in with a darker blue.
Yes. Yellow.
Why should it be yellow?
Because you're so bright.
So bright. Yeah, we're going to put pattern lines on this afterwards.
Oh, okay.
If you're finding that your brush is drying out, I can feel that mine is, which means the paint's not going on smooth, then just dip it in the water. Some people are saying on, some people are saying off. Yeah, I know. Okay, well, I'm going to paint a little bit with it off and then I'll stick them back on, okay? Dark blue and aqua together, David, to make a new tone. Hopefully you should see from this bird that I'm painting that it is a different colour than the wing. Can you see that? Everyone's colour is going to be slightly different, Daisy.
More like a teal.
That's okay, that's fine. Now this wing is the same. The thing is, every brand of paint has slightly different tones, and every time they make the paint will be slightly different again, and so everybody's is going to look slightly different, okay? So don't panic about that at all. I need more blue on mine. You okay, boys and girls?
Yeah.
Daisy's just painted her hair. She's in streaks.
I got pink hair.
You got pink hair, awesome.
Well, it's blonde into pink.
Blonde into pink, awesome. I didn't know I mixed blonde, but that's always good. Okay, that's that wing there. This wing here. Notice I've left that wing, people. Don't paint that wing. Okay. that's that wing. Then this wing up here is that colour. What's Dad doing? Doesn't matter, Deeds, don't get disheartened. Blame the teacher. David's getting a bit of grief from Daisy. Apparently he's done something wrong on the bird that I told her is hers. And
no, I don't mind it, I'm just saying.
She's giving him a bit of grief.
I just don't trying to help.
So I'm just painting in the body of this bird at the back, which is Thomas. Wonder if the boys are watching this live, David. Do you think they are?
No.
Not a chance. Not a chance.
None of them even have Facebook, Mum. How can you watch it?
True. Okie dokie. Then this part, this body here of Harry's, is this blue as well? You can see when I'm painting it, because I know that we're going to paint over these lines in black. I'm not being too stressed about, you know, being absolutely exact inside the line. Well, I'm trying to stay inside the lines, of course, but I'm not like painting really, really super carefully, because I know that we're going to be doing a lovely black line around the outside. So that's that colour of blue. Have I got any questions? Right, I'm going to put the lights on for those people that want lights on, so that you get to see it a bit brighter. And now I'm going to mix up my next colour. So here's my palette. That's the colour I had. I'm now going to add some yellow to it, and we should end up with a much brighter blue-green. So I'm going to keep mixing the blue in, but it's going to be a blue-green. I want it predominantly blue still. I don't want it to be an acrid green, but I want it to be a different tone. So you should be able to see that I added some yellow, mixed in until I've got a blue-green. And that's the rest of the birds, so that you end up having three different tones. I'm just going to add a tiny bit of white to that. Can you see? A tiny bit of white, just so it's a bit lighter, or just dripped orange everywhere. That's the downside of having a palette. Okay, so this should be just a little bit lighter and a slightly bit greener in tone.
Mum, is this fine? It's the same colour as the mural we painted, remember that time?
Yep, that's fine.
I can put a bit of white and it's a bit dark.
Yeah, if you add a little tiny bit of white, it'll just brighten it up a little bit. Go around the other side of Dad. Okay, that's that wing. Oh, I see it's there. Sorry, Dad. And then the back wing. And that is all of our pigeons painted, which I'm loving. Loving, loving, loving. What about the bird bottom right? The bird on the bottom right is oranges. So you don't need to worry about him just yet. Actually, this wing here is aqua, so let's paint that one in. Okay, I'm going to wash my brush. And then you can follow me. I need a little swig of wine. Let me know, guys, if you're keeping up and we're going at an okay pace. Am I going too fast? Am I okay? Give me a thumbs up. Give me some love. Tell me to slow down. Tell me where you are in your painting. If you're having any problems, so I can troubleshoot.
We're still making the blue green.
You're still making the blue green? That's fine. Not a problem. What other little story have I got to tell you this week? Well, obviously I spent most of my week making my rig. I have done 3 training sessions on Facebook Live with a lady in Los Angeles on how to improve the whole setup. So it is a bit of a learning curve. Actually, it's more of a mountain. But I've definitely decided that even when lockdown is fully over, I'm still going to do sip and paints for free. I don't know if I'm going to do it once a week, once a month. I don't know when I'm going to do it. But what I'm going to do next week is I'm going to send out to all of you guys the chance. In fact, you're very welcome to do this now. You're welcome to put your email address in the messages below, or you can message me. And I'm going to create a subscription thing so I can let you know when I'm going to do my Facebook Lives, okay? If you want to send it to your friends, please do. This is nothing that, you know, the more the merrier. That's what I'm trying to say. It's not that you're not important. Of course you are. You've showed up. Fair play to you. But if you've got friends that you think might would like to do it, your mum, your auntie, someone else, and you just think, oh, I must let them know, please do. Share the love. I really just want to inspire you to all have a good go. If you've tried painting for a couple of weeks, then next week try pastel. Next week try pencils. Change it up and see. You might unlock a whole new technique that you hadn't even tried before. At the end of the day, you're not paying for it. So if you mess it up, does it matter? No, it doesn't. It really doesn't. I painted a painting this week. Where did that go, Daisy? Which
one?
I painted on cardboard. No, I painted another one. What did I paint on cardboard the other day? I painted a painting on cardboard the other day, just to illustrate. You know, the cardboard is an amazing resource to use. And so, you know, you can use cardboard. You don't have to use canvases. Obviously, this one I've just repurposed. It was one I had in the studio that I probably used about 3 or 4 times. I want to create this community of people that are looking, you know, you perhaps don't want to spend $60 on a Saturday night, plus your taxi, plus your wine, plus your this, to go out and do something that you're sort of interested in, you sort of want to give it a go, but you just don't want to invest that sort of money. Or you might be overseas and you haven't found somebody else that's doing this for free. Well, I am your gal. Helena says, I'm flagging. Oh, flagging as in tired or flagging as in you're struggling? Hopefully you're not struggling. Okay, we're going to go on to orange now, people. I want you to paint these flowers here in orange. Now, historically, orange is a really, and this is going to sound like a bizarre comment, but orange is quite a thin paint, which means that you might end up having the background showing through. So you might have to do a couple of colours. Helena, if you're flagging, then what you could do is just stop, my darling, and you could come back to this tomorrow. Yeah. Flagging means you're tired. Oh. Maybe she's had a busy day. Oh, I know why, because you were painting at Paint Peru today. I saw on your Facebook that you've been painting all day, haven't you? No wonder you're tired. So you could always come back to it. You know the drill. I usually save these. I always save these, and so you can always do it at your own speed, okay? You're tired too. All right, I'll speed up. Shall I? Let's talk.
No.
Let's talk. More action, Mum.
I like talking. This
is fun. So I'm painting in the orange of these flowers. For you ladies that have done a few of these, Why don't you think about turning them into greetings cards or a calendar for Christmas, or, you know, getting them turned into a mug that you could, you know, utilise some of the creativity that you have done and actually, you know, turn it into something. You can give your paintings away, or you could photograph your paintings, scan them in, and, you know, Vistaprint or Big W or Kmart. They all offer those printing services where you can have them turned into presents. I was asking last week what I could do with all of mine, and I'm going to donate mine to aged care facilities, because obviously I've got so many paintings right now. I've started giving away my children's canvas, my children's pictures. So I gave a couple away this week. So as children have been turning up or I've seen them, I've just given them a couple of my paintings because it seemed like a nice thing to do and it brightened their day. I gave away a unicorn picture and I gave away a couple of bits of clay to a couple of kids that they went home and painted. Okay, I'm just going to put yellow or orange in the centre of that pink. Yes, Daisy?
Okay.
What's the matter, Daisy?
What's the matter?
And then this guy down here is going to be stripy in orange and green. So I'm just going to put the stripes in. And then we're going to put the green stripes in. Again, like I said, orange tends to be quite a thin colour. You might need to do, well, mine is definitely a thin paint. And I don't know why. It must be about how they mix it up. And to be fair, I'm using inexpensive paints. So if you're using high quality acrylics, you'll have much better pigment. But I'm just using, you know, a lower quality Montmartre paint, because when I'm here at the studio with the kids, or if we're doing sip and paints, you know, it's beginner's stuff. So you don't want to use really expensive paints. But it does mean often with yellow and orange, you have to go over a couple of coats, but that's okay. We can do that. And don't forget, if you've had enough, you can just pause, sit back, have a cup of tea, have a glass of wine, just watch me, and then you can finish it tomorrow, okay? You don't have to finish it now. Don't feel like you have to. This flower over here is orange. That flower is orange. That flower is pink. That flower is orange. Okay, with the rest of my orange, I'm just going to go over this flower a second time where it's a little bit see-through. And then we're going to move to lime green. Alright, that's my orange completed. Let's see if we've got any messages. Going slow, already painting for 8 hours today. Oh my gosh, bless you. Hello Jack Wilson, welcome. I saw the, Nicole says, I saw you the water lilies one that you did. It was on cardboard, wasn't it? It was amazing. Oh, thank you. Yes, it was. Yeah, that's right.
It's the one on the ground.
Where?
On the ground.
Oh yeah. Okay, I am going to, I'm going to have to bend down for this because it's at the bottom of my canvas and you can just follow in, but I've got to paint all of the green. It's the lime green colour and it's right at the bottom, so I'm actually going to have to kneel down on my poor knees and I'm going to paint in all of this area underneath. It's kind of like the grass If you haven't got a bright limey colour, if you add yellow, you will get that limey colour that you're looking for. So if you've just got a forest green or a dark green, add a bit of yellow and you'll get the limey colour. Oh, my knees. These colours are popping. What do you reckon, Daisy?
Yeah.
They are popping. David, you okay?
I'm good.
You're good. Okay, so I'm just going around these flowers at the bottom. Luckily, it's nice solid colours today, isn't it? So it's super easy, no blending. Nice, bright, easy colours. David likes a nice, bright, easy colour. Is that right, Deeps?
Deep.
I've done that bottom bit in around the wing there. And turn around, look at the picture. Yep. And then this bit here is green here as well. Loving the brightness. Daisy, should we put this up in our house?
Yeah.
So we'll finish this green and then we'll take a little walk around with the camera again. And you can see Daisy and... Why are you saying, oh my God, why?
I like
them. Oh, Daisy. How can you say you don't like it? Then
like
all of this...
Painting, I just don't like mine.
Okay. All of this around... This funny little bird here, all around the orange one, that's all green as well. Ooh, bit tricky around there in that corner, tiny bit. In and around his head. And around that one there, all of that is bright green. Up around the top of that flower, and then in around this random little red chicken at the bottom. Not sure what sort of bird. I'm sure they're kind of native to Peru. We'll have to ask Enrique what sort of bird they are. He's decided that 4 a.m. is way too early to get up. I'm not getting up at that time and I don't actually blame him. But I'll make sure that I send him or copy him in so he can see everybody's artwork. So I'm sure he'd love to see it. Okay, that's that green bit all done. Okay, and while we've got the green, we're going to do the green stripes of this guy. Actually, we're not because it's still wet. Leave that guy because he's still wet. Hopefully, most of your painted has started to dry off now. I know mine has. So I'm going to make a slightly lighter pink. So my cerise colour, I'm adding in a little bit of white to get a bright pink. It's slightly lighter than the pink that I had before. And these flower centres are going to be in this brighter, lighter colour. So it's just the pink that I had before with a bit of white. This, I think, would be a really nice painting if you wanted to do it in oil pastels, because oil pastels have an amazing, like, vibrancy to the colour. So you get really bright colours. I think it would be, I think it would work brilliantly in oil pastel. Alright, so let's see, how is everybody doing? Are you all okay? What bit are you up to? How are we doing for time? It's 10 to 9, so we are probably into the detailing stage. We're not far off. So I've got a random flower I missed up here, so I'm just going to paint it in pink. Paint it whatever colour you want, it doesn't really matter. But let's find out where you're at so we know how far you're going. Well, I reckon in 15 minutes we'll have this painting all finished. Seems like an impossibility, but we're gonna motor on. So just painted that with a pale white center, a pale pink, sorry, center. Awesome. So we've pretty much painted everything, which means that we're now really, you're still on the grass? Okay, no worries, Diane. But we're pretty much now onto doing the detail part of it all and drawing all of the line work. Hey, that'd be good, you too. I'm going to take the camera around and you can see the guys. Okay, let's have a little look. Flip you around. Oh, look at Daisy's face. Laugh, everybody, Daisy. Can we all tell Daisy, is her picture looking bad? No, it is not, little lady. That looks lovely. It's gorgeous. Maybe you're this beautiful one here. Maybe you're the beautiful one in the middle. David, that looks pretty impressive. Very nice, good job. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I've put a little baby chair there and I'm gonna start to, what, Daisy?
What about the chicken?
What about the chicken, good point. Let's color in the chicken and then I'm gonna start the detailing. Okay, the chicken is a red color. Let me just put you back in the clamp. All right. So we need to mix up a red colour. You can use red out of the tube, but I want it to be slightly duller. So I'm adding red out of the tube, and I'm adding a tiny spot, I don't know if you can see that, a tiny spot of purple. I don't want it too purpley because I don't want it too burgundy. And we'll paint that bird into that colour there. So I don't want it to be dark purple, but I don't want it to be like scarlet red. So I've just added a bit of purple into my red and it's just taking it into a almost like a burgundy red. And then we'll let that one dry as we do the other bits of the other birds. So while that's drying, we'll be able to do all the detailing of the other plants and birds. Let's do that wing there. It's quite low, this easel, for me. It's a children's one. But I had to use this easel because of the width of my canvas. But it's quite low to scooch down on. But I couldn't put it on my normal easel because it was too thick. Okay, so there's my red chicken or whatever it is. So I'm going to use my my little brush, my pointy brush. And the first thing I'm going to do is put the centres of these flowers in. And the centres of these flowers are pale pink. So if you've still got some pale pink left over, I need some more white. Where's the white? Okay, can you see me? Yep, awesome. Can you see me? You can see my head. Okay, we're going to put in the, it's like an egg shape in the centre of that flower there. Beautiful pale pink egg shape. Doesn't matter what tone it is, just long as it's lighter than the, you know, than the flower that you had there before, the outside flower. And then the same on this one. Slightly rounder in the middle, a nice little round little centerpiece of that flower. This one here, the center is over there. So it's half of it is behind this random little birdie thing here. And then we're going to paint in this guy's little head is the same pink. And I know that some of you are going to be a little bit further away than me. And that's okay. I mean, I have to keep going, otherwise we'll be here till 10 o'clock. So I need to just keep on painting on. And you guys, that you'll catch up and you'll be able to finish. But you can see where I'm going. I'm going colour by colour, piece by piece. Pink with white to make the light pink. And then you do those center flowers. And then while those center flowers dry, I'm going to start to do my patterning of these birds. And this is just in that bright pink. So three lines going across. One. You might need to do these a couple of times, depends on how dry your painting is. If you're using pencils, you might like to do this with a Sharpie or a texture over the top to get the brightness. One, two, three. And then we've got a row of little dots around its neck. We've got three across his tummy this way. I don't know what these lines and symbols mean, but I do know that Enrique said that they symbolize the ancestors of Peru. And then there's three on the tail area. And then we've got three lots of three on the wings. Do you know what? I know it's very important for his painting that they have exactly the amount of lines, but I'm pretty sure that if you're using this as inspiration, if you haven't got room to do all the lines that I've done, then just do some. Just do some, just do some dots, or if you wanted to, then why not create your own patterns? I'm sure that is completely fine as well. So I'm doing the next pigeon now. When I'm concentrating like this, I can't chat. Have you noticed? David just said concentrate more. That's rude, David. Yeah. So I'm putting in these lines. If you feel like you need to, you know, stop, then please do. You can always come back and finish it. I don't want you to, obviously, but if you are flagging, I know, Helena, you've done 8 hours of painting. Totally understand. You know, you've got Mother's Day tomorrow. I want you to enjoy that. Deeds, if you want to stop, stop. No one's making you. It's supposed to be pleasurable. So if you're getting to a point where you feel like you've had enough, then just stop. David, nobody's forcing anyone here. You want to do it because you want to do it, not because you feel like you have to do it. Art is about love. If you don't put the love into it, it just misses it. I can't stop, obviously, otherwise these guys will never finish the picture. So I've done two pigeons, I'm now going to go. So the pattern work is slightly different on this one. He has a bit of a triangle under his arm. Having to stand in front of the canvas because I can't paint to one side when I'm doing it direct like this. It's probably not very good for you guys, but you just have to bear with. Daisy, do you want to go home to bed, sweetie?
No.
Well, you can.
I know, I like it doing it.
But if you're feeling tired, darling, you can go home to bed. It's absolutely fine.
I'll keep going.
Right. Why don't you go and get a glass of water, maybe? Didn't need to pick that. No, I'm good. You alright, Dave? Mm-hmm. Daisy, can you have a look and see if anyone's written me any messages that I need to be aware of? No?
No.
Really hard to chat and draw straight lines. It's just impossible. You have to concentrate. I want to chat, but I can't. It's impossible.
I'm going to make it quick for the house.
That is true. Going over some of those lines there where they've dried through and they've gone a bit opaque. So I'm just adding it like a little bit of extra paint over the top. Okay, so I've got two more birds up. So that bird there needs to have its dots around its neck. Two rows of dots. Okay, done the wing, I've done that wing. He's got three more lines here. One, two, three. Okay, then this bird up here. David, love, why don't you go home? Take Daisy home.
No, I'm fine, Mum.
I can hear David's flagging. I can hear Daisy's flagging.
I'm not, I'm fine. Perfectly fine. I can run around this whole building, I'm fine.
Dee, do you want to go home, Mum? Pink. I need a bit more pink. Okay, I might turn the lights off just so that you can see it without the reflections. And it just might help with the colours. So you can see the colours punching forward. I've nearly finished my pink. I know that you guys will still be going. But I've just nearly finished my stripes. Seems to be the pattern seems to be stripes of three under the arms. If the arms are up, it seems to be like a what do you call that? A triangle kind of pattern. But the rest of them seem to be like groupings of three stripes. So I don't think it matters really where you put them. You know, we're not going to get too precious over that. And then round the neck is where you've got these two rings, almost like a necklace of spots. One, two, three, going down. One, two, three, and then three at the tail, one, two. And if your birds, if you don't have room for three, we'll just put two lines. It doesn't really matter, does it? I mean, I know it did when Enrique painted it, but Enrique, we're using your painting for inspiration, okay? So we're not going to get too wild and crazy about making sure that it's exactly right. It's an interpretation of it. And that's fine.
I think it's kind of coming together.
Coming together? That's awesome, Daisy. Good to hear. Daisy's just said after about an hour of saying she hates it, it's finally coming together. We're glad we think that, Daisy.
A little bit.
All right, good job. So I think my birds are done in terms of my stripes. I'm now going to put in the whites of their eyes and then I'm going to go on to the flowers below. So I'm just going to get a blob of white and I'm going to put a white eye in where the eyes are. One, two, three, one over here, and one over there. Okay, I'm going to let those whites of the eye dry. Going to try and paint the rest of my snaky bird. And hopefully you can start to see where things get done. So if you're ahead of me, or if you're waiting for me, then you can just carry on. You can see that I'm doing this green now, the green stripes. So you can crack on with that. Funny little snaky bird. I don't know what sort of bird he is. He's an odd one. He's a weird looking one, isn't he, Daisy? A stretchy bird.
Oh, just dropped it. Paint power.
No, just dropped the brush. Okay, what about the chicken? I've done the chicken grass down. How are we all doing, guys? Haven't had any comments. You've all gone to sleep or you've all left me? How are you going? Give me a bit of a chat. I know it means you'll have to put your paintbrush down, but let me know how you're doing. I think we've got 24 people still painting, so we've lost a few. A few people have gone. It's too tiring. Gone.
What are we using the yellow for?
The yellow's at the very end, Daisy. So I think we need to start wrapping this up. It's 10 past 9. We've been going for an hour and 45. So we want to start getting going. So I'm going to motor on now. Well, I've been on for 2 hours, but I haven't been painting for 2 hours. So we're going to put this aqua blue. You're going to put some blue stripes in your flower. So hopefully your pink has now dried. And we're going to put these lovely blue stripes. And to be honest, guys, you can put them wherever you want. And that beautiful contrast I love. Loving it, loving it, loving it, loving it. So we want them to go in towards the centre of the flower. And I couldn't have painted these earlier because if your pink was still wet, then it's just going to make a smudgy brown colour. And that is not the vibrancy we want. So the problem is you have to kind of wait for long enough that it dries. Oh, I love that. That's gorgeous. Daisy, do you like that?
Yeah.
It's awesome, isn't it? So we're just going to paint these stripes in our pink flowers. And then it's a case of black lining. And we're nearly there. Woohoo! It's quite a lot in this painting, actually, more than I expected. Which is probably why we're still going. Some of the paintings, when you're just doing a very easy blend, obviously it doesn't take very long. This one is a little bit more complex. I thought it seemed really simple, but actually now I'm painting it, I'm realising that there's a few layers of things and it's quite a large composition to paint. So well done to you guys for sticking it out. Hopefully you're enjoying painting it. Hopefully you're having fun. You've got a cup of tea or a glass of wine. You're having it, got some music on in the background. You're having a chit chat with your friends. which I'm pretty happy with. And now, the final touch, there is a little bit of detailing to do, but the next touch is really to paint black, the black lining. So you're going to need a small paintbrush. Got a few comments? Okay, I'm just going to get some black. What have we got? Beautiful Karen, signing off totally tired. No problem, Joanna. Thanks for joining us. Concentration Mum. Rob Jury from Cornwall is watching. Hello, Rob. Just painting the green on the lizard thing. No problem to you guys. My birds and flowers are still a bit wet, so I'll finish it tomorrow. So thank you, Jan. Lots of fun. Don't forget, guys, please send me your pictures. I know you're signing off. You're all a bit tired. So sorry it's taken so long if you're hooking off. We're obviously going to finish this. If you're finishing it tomorrow, please send your pictures to me at You Create Our Home. I really want to see all your artwork. I'm going to finish here now, and I'm going to blackline all my picture, and then we're done, okay? So that's what the job is. It's a case of going over your purple lines and blacklining it all. If you're going to look at it tomorrow, then you can fast forward to this part. You'll be able to pick it up from here, and you'll be able to see what to do. After we do this, there's a few spots in the center of these flowers, and there's a little bit of spot action on the face and on our little red bird. I'm not leaving, so if you're still painting, you can still paint with me. If you're signing off, I totally understand. That is all good. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. I've loved having you, as always. All right, I'm going to motor on now. I'm going to do these black lines, and I'm going to get this picture finished. And you'll be able to see how much it comes together now. The black lines make all of the colours pop. It's one of those things that when you started, you just want to finish, don't you?
Yeah.
You just want to finish. So when you're doing black lining, in order to get a nice flat line, just keep your brush moving. Don't try and draw with it, just put it down and let your brush glide and you get smooth lines. If you try and draw with it, that's when you get a really broken line. So you need to let your brush glide. It's really, really important. Push it down, let it glide, let it be smooth and let it just glide and go round. All right? Let it glide and go round. Let it glide and go round. There we go. So everyone thinks that doing line work is really difficult, and it's really not. But it does, you just need to, you know, keep your brush there and let the brush do the work. So instead of your brain saying, oh, I need to draw, you don't. You just push your brush down, and then push your brush in the direction you want your brush to go. But if you keep on lifting it up and putting it down, you get a really broken line and you don't get a smooth line at all. And in this painting, the black line is everything for sure. This is really what's bringing it all together. So it's really important that you get a really nice black line. If your paint is still wet, and it's starting to pull the colour up, then just dip your brush back into the black line, into the black paint, and go again. Don't try and keep pushing it round when the colour is mixing round on your canvas. Just dip it back in to get a really nice black. All right, I'm nearly done these ones. Just doing this flower here. and trying to paint fast and accurately. It's a killer. I think I missed my pink stripes on that bird. Never mind. I might go back and do that in a minute. We'll keep going with the black line right now. As they say, I've started, so I will finish. What program was that from? Mastermind. Did you get Mastermind in Australia, or is that just an English thing? Huh? Well, they had it here. It was definitely a program from my childhood, that one. I don't know what day it used to be on, but I remember sitting watching it with Mum and Dad and Nicola, Alison and Claire. It was very much a family viewing night. Do you remember that, Mum? Perhaps Mum can tell me. Okay, let's move over here so you can see that. So I'm just going around the black line. This is the kind of end of the painting, really. You're just black lining round your painting, round all your bits and bobs. And so we carry on. How are we doing? I've been using acrylic paints. I'm trying to do the black lines with the texture. That's a really good idea. You're going to go over the lines again in the morning. That's fine. I think going over with the texture is a really, really good idea. As a notoriously slow painter, this would take me all day to do, I reckon, but it's beautiful, Karen. Yeah, I agree. I think a texture is a great idea. If you want to go over with a texture in the morning, I think that is a sensational idea. It does take a bit of a steady hand. So if you want to wait for it to dry and go back to it tomorrow, that is absolutely fine. Still on now. What are you still on, Mum? How are you going? Sorry, David?
Mastermind.
Oh, it's still on now. Oh my God. Really? Mm-hmm. Mastermind is still going in this day and age. I can't even imagine that that is even relevant. What a bizarre program to have this day and age. Specialist subject, COVID-19. David, Daisy has no idea what we're talking about.
No. Well, there's a movie called Mastermind.
Is there?
Yeah. Kind of a teeny one. So, about a guy who's below, he's an evil supervillain, but then his arch nemesis. Apparently dies, and he has to become a good guy, and he creates a good guy to fight, but he turns bad, so he has to end up saving the problem.
Oh, there you go.
And turns out his actual nemesis, is, faked his death to stop being a superhero, so he didn't like it.
Well, that is not the same as the Mastermind we're talking about, but that was a very interesting story.
Yeah. And he has like this robot friend. With a fish that can talk. Lives in water, but has a whole body. So
Okay, I'm just sitting down the front because it's so big I can't get round the bottom bit of these birds. Oh. If we had painted this first with a black line, the problem is that when you painted the rest of the colour, you would have lost the black line anyway. And at least this way, when you paint with a purple line, the purple ends up being a shadow. And so it doesn't matter if the purple shows through, that is absolutely fine. But if you'd painted a black, you'd have had a kind of really heavy line behind. So purple is definitely the best colour to use. And I do think the black lines just help to, you know, if you've been a bit clumsy with your painting, it just helps sort of bring everything together. Alright, I'm nearly done the last pigeon. And we're just going around these flowers here. And the centre of these flowers at the bottom have red dots, which I'm going to put in a really bright scarlet dot. There's a lot of line work, isn't there, Dave? Mm. Dave, you like black lines?
Mm-hmm.
You've gone off from that. David's gone off the black lines. All right, I'm nearly done. Well done, Daisy. Good job.
I was finished, but then I realised I have to go around the flower, the one with the blue line, like around the blue area.
Need a touch more black. Oh, that looks nice. Okay, I'm just going around the centre of these flowers. I kind of want to stop, but I kind of don't. You know, when you're at that phase, you're like, God, I'm tired, I want to stop. But you're like, I'm so close to finishing, I'm just going to press on.
Yeah.
I really want to go home. I've really had I'm like, no, I've had enough. But we're so close to finishing. How can we give up? We can't. Come on, push through, people. We're going to push through to the end. Gotta be. It's gotta be so close. What do you reckon, Daisy?
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Focusing.
Focusing. I wish we could play music here, but we can't, because if we played music, Facebook would shut us down because of copyright, so we can't. So that first week, we played it, and I kept on saying, I can't hear the music. Well, it was a good job. Because otherwise, Facebook would have shut the broadcast down. So, hopefully you guys at home have got some music, or you got the radio on. You got your friends chatting away too. My family are all too serious about this, and it's all quiet here.
And there's only three people.
There's only three of us today.
Maybe just five.
Alright, that's my black lines done for that little random fly thing. It's a beautiful, bright picture though, isn't it?
Yeah.
I love the colours.
I'm sure if my black lines have run down.
I think it would have done. Alright, we are nearly there, people. The end is so close. Get this little bird black lined in. Few dots and we're there. Have you done your black line on this bird, Daisy?
Yeah.
Yeah? Good girl. So close, people. Look, I'm nearly done. Going to give you such a big clap for persevering. Oh, that one went a bit wobbly. Just doing the black lines now on these stripes of these flowers, and then that's the last black lines I've got to do. Finishing off this flower here. So close to the end, I can almost taste the winning point.
Yeah.
Yay! That was a big clap. Have you done yours, Daisy? Have you?
Yeah.
Oh, yay! Well done.
Yeah.
Daisy, can you see if anyone's got any messages for me?
Yeah. I'm going to lie in a darkened room.
Who's that?
Nanny.
Nanny? Oh no! Why? What's the matter, Mum? Are you not feeling very well, or are you just overwhelmed? Why is she going to lie in a dark too bright? Have you had too much coffee?
She's not responding.
She's not responding. Maybe she's gone. Maybe she's just lying in a dark room in the bathroom somewhere.
Maybe she's already gone.
Do you reckon? Alright, I'm nearly done. So I'm just finishing off those last few black lines. I've just got this little bit of the flower to do. 10 lines, I reckon I've got. 10, 9, 8, 7.
She just left.
3. God, I actually did have 10. That's amazing.
Yeah.
1. All right. So that's all my black lines done. That was a lot of black lining.
Worth it?
Yeah, worth it. And now we're just going to put in, I'm going to put in the little eyeballs of my birds. So I'm just going around the outside of the eyes. Put in the little black bit of the pigeon.
So Nanny just replied and said, too much, hardest yet.
The hardest yet, okay.
And then Rob N and Sam Newman.
Yeah, that's Pitty's mum.
Yep, looks great. Thanks heaps, Karen. Going to bed.
No worries. Thank you for coming. Sorry it was so long.
Bye.
I'm just going to put the red spots in here. You guys will see this tomorrow. I'm going to finish off this. This was obviously a stretch too far. I think maybe I pushed the boundaries for you all. But I'm just going to finish off this little bit so that you can see it tomorrow. And you can finish it off if you want to. I'm putting in a few little red dots in here. And then we're good to go. All right. I'm going to say to you, bye-bye. Take care. Thank you. Have a lovely night. We'll see you another week. Yep, send photos. Beautiful, beautiful.
Hello.
I'm just going to finish off these last little bits. I'll make it easier next week, people. Let's do an easier one next week. Noughts and crosses. David says noughts and crosses. It was obviously a tricky one, this one. I've pushed you to your limits. I am so sorry.
It was fabulous. Happy
Mother's Day to you all, beautiful friends. I'm just going to carry on and finish this. It's dripping here, that's a bit annoying.
It's worth it. It was worth it. Looks
good. It looks great, I know. It looks fantastic, but it was a big picture.
Especially how you did on a massive canvas. That's probably why.
I didn't realise it would be so long, to be fair. I didn't think it would be as a stretch as this, so that's good to know. So I just want to finish off the little dude down the bottom, because he has like little orange spots on his wings. So we just want to put in the little orange spots. He's a little bit different and he has orange V's. So I'm just going to put in orange, little orange V's. And he needs an eye. A little bird hasn't got an eye.
I gave him an eye.
You gave him an eye, good girl.
A black one. Because he's different, he just gets black.
Awesome! And that's it. That's our painting. Thank you so much. Take a screenshot. There it is. There is our Enrique Bustamante. Thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate it's a really long draw. That's 2.5 hours. I'll scale it back next week, I promise. Mwah! Lots of love. Happy Mother's Day to all those wonderful mothers out there. I hope you've had a fun evening and thank you for joining me. Take care.
sorry. I don't think these lights are good, you know, for paint. Do what?
Have it going on.
How did you find out?
Is it on your iPad?
Yes, it's still on my iPad. But it says stop streaming.
The iPad's a bit